The Rio Grande Plan is a vision for improving the urban infrastructure on the west side of downtown Salt Lake City. Maybe you know the area, but probably not. It's not a very popular place. There are large freeway bridges and a huge empty rail yard surrounded by rows of empty lots. And it is here, right in the middle of all of it, where Salt Lake City, for the last 20 years, has been trying to build its intermodal transportation hub, where trains and buses of all kinds converge. This is actually a really big deal. Because as the Salt Lake Valley continues to grow and urbanize, more and more people will need to rely on public transportation in order to keep our air clean, to provide low-cost access to school and jobs, and if nothing else, to prevent a complete gridlock of our freeways. Salt Lake City's future depends on establishing a top-tier public transportation network, and with our above-average rail system, we already have a really good start. But this intermodal hub and this neighborhood aren't going to cut it. To explain why, and to show the solution, I need to take you on a little tour. Our first stop is here, at the railroad crossing at 900 South and 600 West. This crossing sees up to 70 trains pass through every day, mostly UTA commuter trains that speed through at up to 80 miles per hour, but also freight trains that can often tie up the crossing for dozens of minutes at a time, especially if the train needs to stop. Both types of trains are terrible obstacles for the people traveling along the brand new 9-line pedestrian trail, which is designed to connect the east and west sides of the city, but which is cut in half by these railroad tracks. The railroad crossings along the west side of downtown are a constant source of injuries, near misses, and fatalities, as more and more trains, cars, and pedestrians pass through these little crossings every day. The Rio Grande Plan proposes the elimination of this crossing and at least three other major railroad crossings downtown. Instead of running at grade, the railroad tracks would be moved back to their original location, except with one major twist. This street is 500 West, and up until 1999, there used to be a median reserved for railroad tracks. The right-of-way, both north and south of here, is still open and available, ready for the tracks to go back. But instead of putting them back at street level, the Rio Grande Plan proposes to construct what we are calling a train box. This would be a large concrete box, dug out of the ground, and large enough to handle any sized freight or passenger trains. Similar structures already exist in Los Angeles, California, in Reno, Nevada, and El Paso, Texas, just to name a few. A concrete roof would allow the street to go back on top and would hide the tracks from the public view. Wouldn't something like this be very expensive? Well, of course it would, but unlike other large infrastructure projects, like freeway widening or roadway construction, this project has the potential to repay its price tag or even make money for the taxpayers in the long run. Let me show you how. These are the rail yards between 600 West and I-15. With most local warehouses either closing or relocating, and with railroads moving their yard operations out of downtown, the tracks here are almost always empty. If you were to add up all the land covered by these tracks, you'd get about 50 acres, which is equal to about 5 city blocks. And once the tracks are moved into the train box, all that land will be available to developers. Think of how many housing units or restaurants or parks or office spaces we could build on 5 city blocks. And think about how many other adjacent blocks could be similarly activated if the neighborhood were improved. And now, think about how much revenue all these new businesses and residents would bring to the city. Denver, Colorado, was able to pull off a similar feat by converting 20 acres of rail yards near downtown into a new neighborhood, and their rate of return was over 700%. Other western cities, such as Sacramento, Portland, Seattle, Los Angeles, and Oakland, have similar success stories. At this point, it's not a question of if the Rio Grande Plan can pay for itself, it's how long it will take for the investment to be repaid. And beyond money, there's other benefits as well. I'm now standing below the 4th South Viaduct. It's loud, it's dirty, and I don't feel comfortable here at all. The streetscape on either side is pretty poor because the entire road has become dominated by this enormous freeway-style ramp. There was no way any thriving neighborhood would develop here until this bridge is removed. And once the railroad tracks are moved into the train box, there will be nothing left for this bridge to go over. Without the tracks, 400 South can be rebuilt into a ground-level street, linking downtown to Poplar Grove and the Jordan River. That would be a major quality of life improvement for everyone in the city, both east and west. There's only one stop left to go, and this last one is my favorite. We're back on 500 West, where the train box will go. And this building behind me now? That is the Rio Grande Depot.
The Rio Grande Depot is a beautiful, historic train station built in 1910 to serve the western end of the Denver and Rio Grande Railroad. It carries an amazing history and has been a major city landmark for over 100 years. It is within easy walking distance of many downtown attractions, including the Gateway, the Delta Center, the Salt Palace Convention Center, and Pioneer Park. The Rio Grande Plan proposes to return this old depot to its former glory as the main rail hub of Salt Lake City and the Mountain West at large. The space for the platforms is still there, with elevators and escalators ready to take passengers down to the tracks below street level. Instead of being put off the train in an empty plaza beside the freeways, imagine arriving in Salt Lake City and being greeted by the grand architecture of a proud era in our city's history. Imagine the crowds of visitors and tourists arriving for conferences, conventions, or even the Winter Olympics.
More than being an improvement in efficiency or even safety, the Rio Grande Plan is an improvement in the quality of life of our city. It is about making downtown worthy of the name and better representing the values that we hold as a community.
Do we want the face of our city to be freeway ramps or trains? Do we want to have a belt of urban blight, or do we want a green loop of walkable neighborhoods? Do we want to keep our east and west sides divided from each other? Or can we reconnect our city and fill in the middle ground?
If you think these goals are too big or too lofty to hang onto one project or one train station alone, I disagree. These goals are exactly what this train station was built to do, and it did its job well for nearly 90 years.
If you'd like to learn more, including ways you can help support and promote the plan, visit our website at riograndeplansaltlakecity.org.
Because this plan benefits the entire community, it's going to take an entire community effort to see this thing through. I'm Christian Lenhart. Thanks for watching.